So as a creative professional, the most important thing you have is your data. When I say your data, that means your videos, your photos, your files. So how are you managing them today? Are you still using multiple hard drives where you've got multiple copies of them and you're not quite sure which is the newest version and which drive it's on and worried that one of these drives is going to die? Maybe you're backing up to the cloud, or maybe you even have a RAID system. So the thing I want to ask you is, have you heard of or even considered using a NAS? Which brings in today's sponsor. So NAS is an acronym for Network Attached Storage. So we're going to look at the UGREEN NAS DXP4800 Plus. This can hold up to 112 terabytes of data. So you can put all of your data together onto this one machine. And then Network Attached means that you have access from anywhere. This is like your private cloud. So let's unpack this, set it up, and then talk about the different benefits and features as well as test this out. Okay, let's open this. In the back here, I see it says magnetic dust mesh filter. So that means we can just snap it on there. Oh, that's really nice. So we can take that off, clean the dust off, and away we go, protects the fan in there. Now in order to transfer data in here, we've got USB 3.2, we've got two USB 2s, as well as two Ethernet slots here. One of them's up to 10 gigabits per second, the other one is 2.5 gigabits per second. On the front, we have four bays. It comes empty, we can put our own drives in, which we will in a moment. We have the power, we have a USB-C, a USB 3.2, and an SD card reader. So these are all different ways of getting our data into this storage. And one interesting thing about this, if we look on the bottom, we can actually have some slots in here. Let's have a look at these quickly. You can use the included screwdriver to open this. And if we look in here, we have two slots for NVMEs. So I've got a couple lying around, so I'll probably pop a couple in there. And this is the RAM, and we can add more. It comes with 8 gigs, and it's expandable to 64 gigs. All right, so they told me this is beginner friendly. We're about to find out. Although I have owned RAIDs before, this is my very first NAS, so I've never set one of these up before. We're gonna see how easy it is. In this case, UGREEN were nice to give me four 4-terabyte drives, which is going to give me 16 terabytes of capacity. In order to put the drives in, we just simply push the button here, pops it open, slide out, and then we can put the drives in. So we can choose any capacity all the way up to 112 terabytes. Now, what we want to do is push this little thing here, and that will slide that open. And then we're just going to take our hard drive, place it in here. Close it, you'll feel it click. That's it, it's locked in. Now you could put an SSD in here, and this is a 3.5 inch. If you want to use a 2.5 inch drive, you know, like a laptop drive, you could use that as well. That's what the screws are for. Now to put it in here, it's just as simple as just sliding it in and then push that. Now it's locked in. Now in order to prevent you accidentally pulling these out while it's running, you can use the key. And if we turn the key, that will lock that bay so you can't accidentally open it. Okay, so some of the benefits in having a NAS, once it's attached to the network, that means I have access to these files no matter where I am. So I can access this remotely, I can download the app and I can use a password and I can get into the system from anywhere, which means I can download files remotely from anywhere in the world. I can also share files. So if I'm working with somebody else, I can give them access, just kind of like a Dropbox transfer link. And then having access to this anywhere, I could access it through Wi-Fi in my house, or I can access it anywhere in the world. So that's the big advantage in having the NAS. Now, there's some really cool apps and features in here, which we're gonna have a look at. Now, the nice thing about having a 4-drive bay, there's actually two advantages to that. One of them is when it sets up in a RAID format, which means that they're writing to the 4 disks at the same time, but it's using the brain in here to intelligently write to the different disks to optimize speed, but also what it does is it creates redundancy depending on how I set it up. If you go into RAID 0, it's just gonna work with all the drives together. It's gonna give you the maximum speed and capacity, but there's no redundancy. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be using RAID 5 today. So if we move this to RAID 5, in this current configuration, this is gonna give us 12 terabytes of usable storage. What it's gonna do is it's gonna use the other 4 terabytes for redundancy, meaning that if a drive dies, if any of these drives die, the data is safe on the other 3 drives and we're able to put a new drive in and it will rebuild and theoretically we're gonna lose no data. So that's one of the great advantages of having a RAID. Now, when I say that, it doesn't mean you shouldn't have other backups. So depending on how paranoid you are about data, you could just get another RAID system or a large capacity drive and just back it up so then you have a copy of each. But if something happens in your location, then either one, you could back it up to the cloud, but then you'd be paying for all that cloud storage again. Or the other thing you could do is even get another one of these, put it into another location. So here's a little idea. You have a trusted person that lives in a different location, maybe a family member. If you were to get one, and they were to get one as well, you could use half of this for you, half of it for the other person, and same in their location. So both of you are gonna have a backup of your data off location. That's just another thought. And of course you can control access to the different files and different parts of the drive through the access control. All right, let's see how easy it is to get this set up and running, and then we're gonna look at some of the features. Okay, let's see if we can find it on the system. There's my device. Okay. So we've just registered it, and this is going to give us remote access. Okay, and here's our welcome screen. So let's just click on start. Okay, so now we're going to create a volume. Okay, let's get started. We're going to create a storage pool, which is going to be the 4 drives. We're going to go for RAID 5. This is a recommended one. Okay, so that's done. So that can take anywhere from 6 to 24 hours, depending on the size and the type of RAID. The RAID 5 does take longer to build. Now, you can use it while it's building, but in this case, I just let it go overnight. All right, so let's go ahead and we're going to create a personal folder. So we're going to hit enable. And then the location is going to be on our volume. And here I am, this is for the admin, which is me. We can add users, by the way, and we'll look at that in a moment. And at this point, we could actually start to put files in there. But if we choose upload, we could upload files, click OK. Okay, so we've got 3 ways to go there now. We can do it through the app. We can do it through the web browser. And we can also access the files here from just connecting to the network right here. So that's 3 different ways on there. All right, and there's more things we can do. We can go into the App Center and you'll see there's a ton of apps here, but I do want to install their photo app. So once you've got the NAS set up, you can use it for many things. One of the things I like to do is use it like a media server. So say for example, I like to work on my desktop a lot of the time, but here I am in the house on my laptop working on something, got some files here, so I don't have to put them on a thumb drive or email them to myself or anything like that. I can just drop them onto the NAS right here from my laptop, and then I can go to the desktop, and those files are gonna be there. They're gonna be available from any computer or my phone as well. So far I've set this up as personal, where I'm the only one using it, but you can add other people. And we can do user management. To do that, go to the control panel, and then click on user management. And then we add people by going add. Now, what if we want to invite somebody that we want to share a file with? Okay, that's great. Let's go under files first. And then what we're going to do is we're going to create a shared folder. And why don't we create this shared folder, and we're going to click here and we're going to call it work. And click create. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back into the control panel, user management, and now we're gonna invite someone. And I'm gonna choose add, and I'm going to invite. Now the users can be invited in various ways, QR code or a link. So I could be anywhere in the world right now, maybe on a laptop, whatever, and I get this invite. I just simply click on here. So now I'm gonna apply to join. All right, and as an administrator, I can now go into the control panel and notice that I've got a notification that's telling me something. And if we go here, what have we got here? Invite. Application list, and look at that. Now, if we choose permissions and settings, there's our work, and we're gonna have read-write access, click save. So why don't we put something in here? Here's a 2.75 gigabyte file, and I'm gonna upload this, and let's see how long it takes to upload. So here we are, we're uploading it right now. Done. Okay, and just for comparison, why don't we upload that same file to Dropbox, and we're gonna see how long that takes to upload. All right, finally done.
So the person that's gonna collaborate on that project can be anywhere. So right now, you just take that QR code, and that gives you the login screen here, and then just put in your username and password that you created, and then just hit login. And right now I'm just hotspotting on my iPhone to my laptop, to my MacBook Pro. And look at this. Here we are. We are now logged in to the NAS.
So let's have a look. Yeah, if we go under files, the only files here are the ones that shared with us is the work folder. And if we go under here, all those files are there. Now, notice if I click on photos, no, they're not going to get access to the whole photo library. They only get access to the folder that's been shared with them.
So the UGREEN NAS has two international authorized certifications for security. So it's very secure. Also, your data here is not shared with anybody. It's just on your local network. So UGREEN don't have access to this. No one has access to this except for you and the people that you choose to share it with.
Let's have a look at the phone app. Back to the home page, and let's have a look at some of the things we can do on the phone right now.
You want to download the UGREEN NAS app, and now we can just open it. And as you can see, you know, I can also access the apps and the different things, but one of the things I'm going to look at here is the photos. So here I can access my photos from anywhere. So if we look at this, you know, I can just go through here, all the albums are there, all the folders are there, even this image here is an image from a Hasselblad. So this even supports the Hasselblad RAW. We can see this is a Sony RAW file. And it even supports RAW files, including all the popular formats from today's cameras. So we can do a search. So maybe I'll do something like Hoover Dam. And here we can see we have personal library and image recognition. So this actually uses AI to search your photos. And look at this. Here's the Hoover Dam. So as you can see, we can use AI to search these photos because I have, you know, 100,000 photos on here, and it makes it very easy for me to search through these and find things using that AI. So this AI is private, just on my photo collection that nobody else has access to, and none of that training is shared with anybody. And we'll look at the settings in a little bit, like how we would do that. And we can go under here and we can see people, and the different people are recognized. So say, for example, I tap on here. This is Lena, but look, here's all the photos from the photo shoot I did with her. And I can just give her a name, and now she's going to be identified. All right, so here we are back at my desktop on the NAS, and I'm going to open up the photos here. Here's the object recognition, which is using the AI. If we go under the tools here, we can choose custom learning, and I can actually train my own model and train it on my photos. Or I can import a model, which I've already done, so I'm not gonna do that right now, because when you do start training, it takes a while. In this case, it took a few days because I have about 100,000 photos in that collection. And this photo app is probably what I'm gonna be using this for the most. UGREEN's giving us 15% off, so check out the links and the code there in the comments. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments underneath what you think about this. And if you are new to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.